August 13th, 2010, 53 degrees 32 minutes north, 5 degrees 32 minutes east. Fleur de Passion is navigating in the Wadden Sea. The shallow sea is situated between the German and Dutch mainland and their respective islands. The goal of the expedition is to gather information on best practices of these marine protected areas. They have been classified World Heritage by the UNESCO in June 2009. The Wadden Sea is one of the largest wetlands in the world. It is a dynamic ecosystem consisting of islands and extensive tidal sand flats, which are continually changing shape. Thanks to this tidal and coastal island system, the region contains a huge variety of plants and animals. Shellfish, crustaceans, and worms live in and on the tidal flats. A great diversity of birds profit from this environment. A large amount of food and tranquility dominate the area and make the Wadden Sea particularly appropriate for migrating birds seeking a winter home or tanking station. Our expedition starts in Bremerhaven to discover the German national parks. After a short stop in the touristic island of Helgoland, we reach Borkum and then continue our route in the Dutch Wadden Sea. We first visit Vlieland. Our trip ends in Den Helder, just across the island of Texel.
This morning I woke, restless and heady, with blood pulsing fierce in the vein. There's light on a line this morning and maybe forever. I move with regard for the sun.
The Wadden Sea landscapes and wildlife are unique, and as many other places in the world, the region is endangered. Pollution, tourism and overfishing are all factors which influence the stability of this fragile environment. It is necessary to take action for protecting its important habitat. The Antinea expedition has arrived on the island of Vlieland. We meet Peter de Boer from the Sovon Institute, the Dutch Center for Field Ornithology. He brings us to a restricted zone of the island where he shows us the wild birds living in the area.
Wadden Sea is both important for breeding birds and for migrating birds. There's about 30 species of waders that breed in Arctic Siberia and in Greenland. A part of the birds, they stay in the Wadden Sea. They stay here all winter until they leave again to the breeding grounds. And another part just uses the Wadden Sea as a step over. They feed here, stay here for a couple of weeks, and then they move on to Western Africa, where they spend the rest of the winter.
To protect this exceptional biodiversity, the whole island is a nature reserve.
Half of the dunes of Vlieland are open to the public and the other half is closed during the breeding season. So when the birds lay eggs and raise their young, the dunes are closed. And in the other time of the year, that half is open to the audience. The other half is opened year-round and people can walk along the tracks and look at the nature.
The birds living in the Wadden Sea strongly depend on the water. Their life is conditioned by the rhythm of the tides.
With every tide, new nutrients come into the Wadden Sea on which the birds feed and on which the shellfish feed on. So it's an ongoing system and one can do without the other.
Fleur de Passion has left Vlieland for Texel. We are spending the day with a group of five scientists from IMARIS working to understand what determines mussel bed stability. Despite the heavy rain, they bring us to the new installations of mussel seed collectors. Those provide fishermen with a sustainable alternative to trawling for mussel seed.
In springtime, they bring nets into the Wadden Sea, and mussel seeds larvae will attach to these nets and grow. And only a few months later, they will harvest these seeds and they will bring them to their culture lots. And there they will grow to market size. At the moment, the fishermen, they can catch about 20% of the needs they have for mussel seeds on these seed collectors. This also means directly that they will close 20% of the seed beds for fisheries. And in this way, in 2020, we'll hope that they will reach 100%. So that no more trawling of seeds is necessary and that everything is caught and seed collectors.
Guided by a researcher from Imares, we take a walk on the mudflat. Mussel beds are the coral reef of the Wadden Sea. They build reefs on soft sediments and are referred to as bioconstructors because they create a stable habitat for many benthic creatures. In the late 80s, intertidal mussel beds declined due to the combined effects of storms, poor recruitment and exploitation from fishery. A recovery plan between fisheries and nature conservation parties was hence established. This plan consisted to close intertidal areas for fisheries.
The re-establishment of a large proportion of intertidal mussel beds is for both parties very important for the commercial exploitation of mussels. We currently have great development in the seed fishery and the aquaculture industry for nature conservation within the framework of Natura 2000 and the World Heritage Site as a whole. The Wadden Sea is a very important feeding area, so I think the play between commercial interests and environmental interests in the Wadden Sea, particularly when with respect to mussel beds, fall very much on the same page.
Protected and preserved, the Wadden Sea is a good example for a successful management plan. This effort has been awarded a nomination of the area as a World Heritage Site by the UNESCO.
To become a World Heritage Site, you have to involve the local population. And this has taken many, many years also to in a consultation with the German and with the Dutch local communities. But this has been, I think if we look back on this process, has been a very, very fruitful discussion. What we can already see now, though it's only a year since it has been included in the list, is that people are proud of being included in this list. And this proudness, I'm sure, will have implications also for their attitude toward the protection of this list and in their way in which they will present in their own responsibility to visitors.
Our mission in the Wadden Sea provides us with useful information on the benefits accrued by marine protected areas to the sustainable management of ecosystems. This will complete the information gathered earlier in the expedition and will help us to develop a global strategy for decreasing the impact of human activities on the oceans.